Welcome everybody to this tutorial. Today I will talk a bit about permissions, how you can change them, how you can read them, and what they are in general. So first off, let's just go ahead and open up a file. So don't worry about this command that I'm going to use now. It's called cat. I will explain it a bit later on when we go into text editing and phrasing and extracting text, formatting it in general, but for the time being, just leave it be. You'll see soon enough what it does. It just pulls the content out of a file and then prints it out to the screen. So I'm just gonna I have a file here, it's called mode, and in that file I've made a small demonstration of I wouldn't say demonstration, but an example of syntax of how this thing actually looks like. So you pass in the command, so you pass in the command, which is chmod, and then where it says owner, group, world, and path, path is basically path to the file of which you wish to change permissions. Owner is changing the permissions for the owner, group is changing the permissions for the group, and world is basically changing the permissions for anybody who can physically access the computer. I will shortly explain what this actually is. So let's go ls mode. There we go. So down below you see that the first spot signifies what is it? Is it a directory or is it a file? Is it a link? That I've already explained. Next three fields basically tell you the permissions which this user has. So what does the owner, by the way, this here, this is the owner of the file. So what does this, what sort of permissions does this owner have? It has a read permission, so it can read the file. It can see the contents of the file, would be a more simpler way of putting it. It has a write permission, so W. This is basically a permission to edit and alter it and modify the file, change it. It does not have the permission to execute the file, although if I am the owner of the file, I can give myself the execute privileges as well. However, until I do so, I will not be able to execute it at all. I know that mode is not an there is nothing to execute in it, but still. Suppose there was a script here which was to be executed, and unless I actually gave it execution privileges, there would be no other way I could do this. Then the next three spots signify permissions for this particular group. So any users belonging to this group will have this set of permissions here. So again, the group can read, it can modify it, but there are no execution privileges for the group. Next up, it's the world. And by world, I don't mean the whole globe or anything of a kind. Rather, instead, I am referring to all the people who can actually log into the computer. Everybody can read this file. Everybody can view the contents of this file without any problems. So let's just go ahead and create a new file with touch. Just type in touch like this, and how shall we name this file? Well, I don't know. I'm running out of inspirations here. So let's name this file Linux. Actually, no. Let's call it Red Hat. Excellent. So we've created Red Hat, and let's see what are the permissions for Red Hat. Well, sorry, not ls. Excellent. So we have the same set of permissions as we do with the mode. Now, let's say we're going to use this file in order to run our tests on it. Before we do, let's just go up a little bit and see what basic permissions do we have. So as I mentioned before, have read, write, and execute. Those are the three basic permissions that you can give to a file, to a user actually, or to a user group for a particular file. They have their numeric values. They have their you see these letters here. They also signify their values. There are also representations of them, let's put it so. However, numeric values are far better. You can use R, W, and X plus minus in front to quickly alter the permissions for the owner of that file. However, if you wish to conduct major changes, you can do it in this fashion. So let's say that 7, it's basically 4 plus 2 plus 1, as stated here, is read, write, and execute. 6 would be 2 plus 4, which is read, write. 5 is 4 plus 1, so read, execute, and so on and so forth. And if this doesn't seem quite as clear as it should, don't worry about it. A lot of people got confused here. I got confused here. But it all really sinks in rather fast, so no need to panic or anything of a kind. Let's go ahead and clear the screen. I'm going to go ahead and cat this out. And let's say that I want to change the permissions of the file Red Hat. So let's do LL Red Hat, just to see what, just so that we have the overview of what they are at the moment. Now let's type as the upper syntax says we should. Let's go ahead and type in the command, so chmod space, and what sort of permissions shall we give it? Well, let's first think about what sort of permissions do we want our user to have. Let's say that we don't want him to actually be able to change the file, but I want my owner of the file to be able to read it and execute it. Let's go ahead and conduct such a change. So read and execute would be 4 plus 1, that's 5. So the first argument is 5. That's what the owner of the file can do. Let's see what now, what sort of permissions do we want to give for the group? Well, I want the group to be able to do the same thing actually. Let's not change anything here. We want a group to be able to read it and to execute it. And the world, well, we're not going to really change anything for the world, as read is way more than sufficient for the world. So let's just leave read as it is and give it 4. So it's chmod 554 that I have typed in space, and then I type in the name of the file. Also, notice that here it says path. Since I am in the same directory where the file that I wish to modify is located, I could also, if I was elsewhere in the file system, I could type in, I don't know, I could go about things like this. So home random guy Red Hat, and this would change it for home random guy Red Hat. Oh. Excellent. So you see, you can compare the previous permissions to the current permissions. You see that this has immediately changed. It says that the user can read and execute, the group can read and execute, the world can only read. Suppose I want to quickly add a write to the owner of the group. I would do chmod without any calculations of whatsoever, or looking at the numbers or anything of a kind. Just type in chmod plus x, and here we're gonna need the name of the file, Red Hat. Let's see what we have done. Oh, actually we haven't done anything because it already has execute privileges. Sorry, I'm gonna add write privileges. That's what I wanted to do. Excellent, so how does this look like now? So the user can actually read, write, and execute. So here it can read, not write, and execute. And now we have changed effectively for the group as well. The group now can actually read, write, and execute. And here read, write, and up here it's read, no writes, and execute, but it's here it's read, write, and execute. Okay, we have changed our minds. We no longer wish to give the write permissions. Let's say chmod minus w. What has happened? The w is gone, as you can clearly see. So these are the quick ways of changing the owner and the group to which the file that owns the file as well. Initially I just said the owner, but it's actually the group as well in this particular example. Anyway, there are other things which we can do. Let's just go ahead and clear the screen with this and type in chmod space dash dash help. So what do we have here? This is probably the dash v and dash r are probably the ones most important here, the one that you will mostly tend to use. So verbose output is just to tell you what it is that it is doing, and recursive, well, just read what it does. Change files and directories recursively. So it just goes into the subdirectories of directories, and then it goes into their subdirectories, and then it finds files there, and then it does alteration on the whole string. Here, let me just show you. So we're not gonna, let's see, what do we got here first? Do we have anything of no importance? So we got mode, we got Red Hat. Come on, something. Apparently, okay, I do have a test folder. Let's utilize the test folder. Let's see what it actually has to say on the subject. So what do? We type in, do I have anything in the test folder? Oops, let's just go ahead and check. If we don't, we just need to create. Okay, so we can go ahead and create with touch. Test one, test two, test three. Let's go back a step, do chmod. Oops, I actually don't know what they are first, so ll. Test folder. Excellent, so they all have read-write and no execute privileges. Let's change it to execute privileges. Let's give execute privileges, but if we print the working directory, we're not actually in the test folder at all, rather instead we are outside of it. So how do we go about this? Well, just type in chmod, as you would ordinarily, type in dash r, space, plus x, space, and now we need a path to the file, which is basically test folder, and then change everything inside of it. Excellent, so let's go ahead. Voila, there you go. So you can now compare these results to these results. It has changed everything within that folder, and it has given it these permissions, but when you do it like this, you see that the world changes as well, the group changes as well, and the current user changes as well. So all the permissions are changed, which is not the best of practices. What you can do with ease to avoid this is simply type in chmod-r and then use numbers as I have used them before. In that way, you can be absolutely certain what changes will take effect and what will be changed to what, who will be able to do what, etc. Anyway, here I'm gonna call the tutorial. I'm gonna bid you farewell, and I sincerely hope that I shall see you in the next one.